Patricio Jones and Ricardo Martinez. It's great to be talking with you too. How did we get here? You know, in between the El Indio Belt and Maricunga Belt, where no one was before, and what was the vision to go there and take that ground?
We have so many projects with so many elevation zones, but not enough money to do the drilling. By 2002, we already know that Filo was something huge, because we had 3 grams gold samples on surface on a place called Maranceles, which is almost 4 kilometers to the north of the oxide that was outcropping near the Cyprus porphyry. So essentially, it was a matter all those years of having more targets to drill than money to spend on them. By year 2005, we had drilled borehole 28 at Filo, which was an incredible hole, very, very good grade. It was really dismissed in favor of Jose Maria, leaving Jose Maria for reserves that rather than carry on with the exploration beyond borehole 28 at Filo, mm-hmm. which is understandable, but then it was proven that Filo was something else.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Patricio, I just want to add a couple of technical comments for the sake of all geologists that will hear this. The extent of the alteration of all these systems is great, is huge. So you have the problem, a good problem for a geologist to understand the systems on a flat lane volcanic field with a lot of alteration and with a lot of different colors and a stacking of each alteration. And we had learned in Veladero exploration that the talus anomalies, geochemical sampling was key for different elements and looking into these systems to find the potential ore indicators. So we planned and we did both all these projects. I will say eventually that they were always found with talus geochemistry in the finds. And the anomaly at Vicuña is certainly huge. It's over 7 kilometers long, and in some areas has almost 4 kilometers wide, north, south, east, west. Same thing we applied for the discovery of Jose Maria, which totally concealed deposit, didn't have any outcrop with any shows of copper or any other element, but did have anomalies in the geochemistry in the talus. So we were applying all these in different elevations, in different projects, and that became a finding method for the team. And it was applied by other teams afterwards in different areas of South American Andes.
And when you guys see results that were out last week on hole 41, did you expect results like that, or you just knew it was possible? How do you guys feel when you see those results that came out?
Well, I feel excellent on behalf of the team, the San Juan province and Argentina. It improves the incredible copper potential of the country that is still very much untapped. The district is already one of the classic mineralization areas in the country, and I feel that it could possibly sustain mining investments for several decades. Filo, you're still really open to the north and to the south. And mm-hmm. and if you the controlling factor is a large suture or fault zone, you might expect things like Chuquicamata in size or in grade. I feel is really, really the fact that you mentioned, Adam, the other day, that the district has 20 billion tons of copper, 28.5 million ounces of gold, 350 million ounces silver, I would say, and is still evolving. You know, is still unexplored. Is incredible.
A little bit more of geology, regional geology, which obviously sustain all these expectations that Patricio is talking, and that we have always dreamed of in those years back over a decade or almost two decades ago. The gap was supposedly between the El Indio Belt and the southern end of the Maricunga Belt, but there is no gap. The situation is that the gap was basically a gap in investing, a gap in exploration, a gap in prospection. We thought with Patricio and all the team that were together in Veladero, and after we went different experiences, came back and grouped ourselves into the Prominsa or the earlier, we were always under the Tenke company in those days. Remember that your dad and your grandfather were expecting Tenke to evolve in Africa, and they used the same shell to promote these companies' new investments in Argentina. And that was a good thing because we came with Tenke at 50 cents. And with all this scenario, new properties in Argentina, the stock went up to $1 and $2. And it was always, we were always promoting these new investments in Argentina with your dad and Paul Conover and Patricio. And basically we were expecting this situation to arise and the new area of the gap to be discovered for a new mining district, and that's what is being proven these days. You know, there is porphyries with 24, 25 million years in Jose Maria, and porphyries of the same sort of mineralization and style at 11, 14, and 12 million years, and that's a mix of the two belts of the gap between the Maricunga, 20, 25, 27, 17 million years, and then the farther down south, El Indio Belt, and the continuation to these areas of El Teniente in the south of Chile, where mineralization is younger, you know, because basically that's the gradational decrease of the mineralization age down from the Maricunga to the end of the the Miocene Belt. So there is a potential for more porphyries. I remember early on in the Tenke or the Provincia evolution, we had 25 target areas in that same block that you guys still have as a property landscape owned by different companies in your under your investment. So keep on going. We have to keep on going. That's the continuation of the exploration. And this is a new district with hopefully the next first production, but there is still a lot of exploration to be done.
Nobody has the sum of knowledge or the whole understanding of every type of ore body. It takes time, you know, success takes, you know, a lot of persistence, and you know, there is always, you know, explorationists. We have our skeletons, like Lucas used to say. Sometimes we do fail, but you know, there is a lot of potential to carry on exploration in Argentina, even today, where I'm sure you know that there are at least seven large, very, very good copper projects, besides Filo and Jose Maria, Pachón, El Altar, Azules, Tacataca, and Agua Rica. And all that is undeveloped yet. So there is a lot to be done.
Yeah, it's very easy to see Argentina, you know, come into a top 10, you know, metals producer globally. And as you guys, you know, help, and I call you from time to time, and we push, and now to get Jose Maria into production, the success at Filo makes me even want to speed up the development process at Jose Maria even more so. We know the time it takes to build these projects. I believe by the time Jose Maria is in production, we will define the limits of the monster that is Filo, and we'll be able to start moving on to engineering studies of how Filo could potentially be incorporated into Jose Maria. So with the success of Philo, it just, you know, adds to the fire that we have within us at the lending group to put these projects into production. And I've been getting enough good signs from Argentina, especially San Juan, the people of San Juan, the governor of San Juan, and now in the capital in Buenos Aires with the federal government. I believe that they want to do this. They want to open up the mining sector, and we're going to do it the right way to make sure all stakeholders benefit, and also the environment is kept in as intact as possible. So we continue to drive home hard with Jose Maria, and I wouldn't be surprised to see Dad moving to Buenos Aires to make sure he sees this get done. Thank you, gentlemen, for your time very much.
Okay. Excellent.